Today you'll learn how to animate almost anything without having the need to keyframe at all using a tool called Anim Curves.
So I'm going to demonstrate and explain the Anim Curves on the example of this rectangle that you can see in the viewer right here. First of all, it is important to know that we can only modify one value with the Anim Curves, and that means everything that is a slider control or an angle control, we can modify that with the Anim Curves. Just right click on that, go to Modify With, and then select Anim Curves. However, if you want to animate something with two values, just like the center part, we cannot animate that using the Anim Curves, but there's a workaround that I'm going to explain later in this video. So if you right click on that, go to Modify With, we cannot see the Anim Curves. So first of all, right click on Width, go to Modify With, and then choose Anim Curves. And as you can see right now, with just doing that, I've created an animation. It goes from 0 to 1 over the course of the whole timeline. So now that we have made this animation, we want to customize it even more. So let's go to our inspector window in the top right corner and then click on Modifiers. So in the modifiers, we can see the curve shape, which houses the source and the curve. Then we can see the scaling, which houses the scale and the offset, and the timing, which houses the time scale and the time offset. Let me just explain what offset and what scale is. So offset basically controls the start of the value of your curve, and it is currently set to 0 because the width value at the start of our animation is 0. If I'm gonna type in 0.5, my animation will start at 0.5 and then increase not to 1, instead it increases by 1. So the end right now, 119, is not 1, it is 1.5, and we can see that if we check the end right here, 119, and if we go back to our tools width, we can now see that it is 1.5. So keep that in mind. If you change the offset, you also have to adjust the scale, otherwise it might mess up your ending part of your animation. So if I want my ending still to be 1, I'd have to type in 0.5 in here, because 0.5 plus 0.5 equals 1. And as you can see, my animation starts at frame 0 with a value of 0.5 and then increases by a value of 0.5 to the last frame of my composition, which is frame 119. Then let's move on to curve shape. We skip timing for now because it is easier to explain time scale and time offset by using our spline editor, so I can show you this a little bit better. So if you're working with titles and animations, whatever, I highly recommend you to choose the modifier source as duration. If you create transition presets, you can choose transition. For this example, let's leave it at duration. And then curve, you can choose between linear, easing, and custom. Linear basically is just a linear movement going from whatever values you set here to the end. Now you can choose easing, which will give you in and out pre-made ease animations, just like exponential and exponential. This will just add a nice subtle easing animation to your whole curve, just like so.
But if creating your own plugins using the Anim Curves is a little bit too much for you, I can totally understand that. And if you solely want to focus on the editing process, I highly recommend to check out MotionVFX's new plugin, MCamRig. This is a plugin that allows you to add fake camera movement to a very static shot and even change the position, the rotation, the fading, depth of field, angle of view, the masking, post effects and on-screen controls. And the best part is that it's completely for free. MotionVFX also has a full library of DaVinci Resolve plugins that you can choose from. And my most favorite is the MTuber 3 that I used several times in this video. So click the link in the description, download all the free assets that MotionVFX is giving away, and see whether you like them or not. And if you like them, you can decide to even get a full pack from MotionVFX.
Or if you don't like the pre-made easing in and out animations, you can just select custom and create whatever custom easing animation or animation in general that you want. Let's go maybe with something like this. This should be good. So right now it starts at 0.5, then it increases, then it decreases, and then it increases back again to 1. because that's the curve that I assigned it to be. And you can use the same keyboard shortcuts for this custom curves window as you would do in the spline window. So I can select the point and hit S on my keyboard to smoothen that point out, just like so. And we'll just have a nice smooth movement like this. But now what do the in and out points down at the bottom right there mean? Basically, the endpoint controls what part of the timeline we're currently on, and the outpoint basically controls how intense you want the scale of the effect to be, which is, for this example, let's just use the point at the beginning. The in value is 0 because it is the first frame of our animation, and the out value is 0 because there is no intensity. If we choose the last frame, the in value is 1 because it's the end of our animation or timeline, and the out value is 1 because it's the maximum intensity that we assigned in the offset and scale. So if we were to select this point right here, we can see that the in point is 0.25, which basically is just a quarter of the timeline. And the out value is 0.76, which basically is 3/4 of the effect intensity. So this is what the in and out values do. If we select mirror, this will double the speed of our animation and it will play it back twice. Now if we move on to timing, time scale and time offset, those are two pretty important settings. Time scale basically increases or decreases the overall length of your curve. So to make that a little bit easier for you to understand, let's open up the spline window. So in the spline editor, you can see an exact copy of the curve animation that we just made. And if we use the time scale, this basically just increases or decreases the overall length of your curve. So let's just take a look at this curve in the bottom right here when I'm about to increase my time scale. If I'm increasing my time scale, this will make the animation faster. If I decrease my time scale, this will make the animation slower and smoother and more soft. So let's talk about the time offset. The time offset basically just controls when the curve is about to activate. So if I'm gonna increase my time offset, watch at the first frame right here at frame 0. Let's just put the cursor here. So the cursor is on frame 0. And if I'm gonna increase my time offset, it will just offset the animation like that and it will start the animation later. So these are the most important things that you need to know about the modifiers tab. And as I said in the beginning of this video, now I'm gonna show you also how you can animate the center parts X and Y with the anim curves. So what you have to do is right click on center, go to modify with, and then either choose vector result. Then you can go to modifiers and then vector on rectangle 1. And now you have the distance slider, which basically just moves it left to right. Or if you want to make it move up and down on the Y path, you can choose an angle of 90 and then use the distance slider. Now it goes up and down. Or what else you could do is if you want to animate the center X and center Y part individually, is right click, go to modify with, and then X and Y path. So now you can animate the X path individually and the Y path individually. So this is how you would use the anim curves on something that has two values like the center parameter or the pivot.
So that's a wrap. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If so, please consider leaving a like and a comment. This would mean a ton to me. But anyways, hope you're having a great day. See you next one. Bye.